And Westminster Council's Mozart Estate lecturer Alice Coleman has been given the chance to put her ideas into practice. In her book Utopia on Trial, she says estates like this don't provide the kind of home that people feel happy in. She says the large public areas around blocks only add to a lack of identity and a feeling of being cut off for residents. Walkways let in strangers and vandals, making tenants more insecure.
We have suggested that removal of walkways, putting walls round the individual blocks so that they belong to the inhabitants and not to the public at large. And in the case of the bigger blocks, trying to divide them up and divide up their grounds so that they may be two or three quite separate blocks side by side instead of one. And then finally, trying to make the front of the block into what we call traditional streetscape.
Alice Coleman believes people were happier in the terrace houses of the 1930s, where the pattern made it easier to develop neighbourly relations, cutting vandalism and crime. Now her ideas have been taken up by Westminster Council, who've hired her to put a human face on their problem Mozart Estate.
This estate looks better than some of the older, different estates, you know, all slab-sided. And in fact, this particular estate won lots of prizes for architecture and design. But I think Alice Coleman has got a lot in what she says. I think the design of estates must have a lot to do with the behaviour. Because if you think about it, the people who live on this estate are exactly the same sort of people who live on the little roads and the little houses round it. So why is their behaviour so different? It must have something to do with the design.
Alice Coleman's schemes here will split the estate up into smaller, more private areas that can be watched over by the residents. She and Westminster hope it'll be an experiment that will make the Mozart estate seem more like home. This is Steve Clark for Thames News.